In this problem, there's a bar attached to a spring and a damper, and we're asked to find the damped frequency. So first, what we need to do is we need to displace the system and draw in a free body diagram based on that displacement. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to displace this bar by angle theta. And we're going to stretch the damper. And we're also going to stretch that spring. And so these will create forces, and we'll add these forces, do a moment balance, and then get our equation of motion. Okay, so first we displace and we draw our free body diagram. So the displace, and this is initially valid for all angles, but then we're going to add a small angle approximation, which will limit our solution to just the case of small angles. Okay, so this is theta. I'm going to draw forces in red here for clarity. So at the bottom, we have our force due to the spring, which we call Fk, and it's in the opposite direction of the displacement because it wants to restore the position back to the original position. So it's going to pull the bar back. Then we have a force of the damper, which is going to, again, also try and pull back. So Fc, and then we have the gravitational force, which is Fg, okay? And then we have our reaction forces here, Ay and Ax, okay? And then I'm going to draw in our coordinate system. So x is positive that way, y is positive upwards, and a positive rotation counterclockwise. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to take the sum of moments and equate this to I alpha or I theta double dot. Okay, so the sum of moments, and we're going to take them about A, so we can cancel those reaction forces because we're not interested in them and we don't want them in our equations, is going to be equal to I A alpha. Okay, and IA is also the same. A is going to be this location here. G is going to be at the center of gravity, and A is up here. Okay, so let's do this. So the sum of moments is going to be equal to, first we're going to take that damper force. So Fc times L over 2 cos theta. That's because we're taking this radius here. So this radius here, which is cos theta. And then we have an L over 2 because it's halfway down that length. Plus Fk L times cos theta. Again, we're taking this whole distance here. So here the distance is full L and then cosine theta. Plus Fg sine theta is going to be equal to negative 1/3 ml squared theta double dot. And again, theta double dot is also equal to alpha, right? So now let's plug in Fc, Fk, and Fg. So Fc is going to be equal to Cv. So C is the damper, damping coefficient, and V is the velocity. It's also equal to C theta double dot times L over 2. And not double dot, theta dot. Which is also omega, right? And then we have Fk equal to Kx, which is also equal to k times L over 2 times theta. Okay, and not L over 2, sorry, L, because this is the full length. Okay, so we can plug those in, and then we also have Fg is equal to mg. So we can plug those in, so we have CL squared over 4 theta dot plus KL squared plus MG theta plus 1/3 ML squared theta double dot is equal to 0. So this is our equation of motion. Okay, and now based on this equation of motion, we can determine the effective damping coefficient, spring coefficient, and mass. Okay, so usually we have equations of the form m prime theta double dot plus c prime theta dot plus k theta is equal to 0. And so we can get these effective coefficients by just taking the terms in front of these coefficients. Okay, and then with this, we can calculate our frequency. Okay, so we get the following. C prime is going to be equal to this term over here, so whatever is in front of the theta dot term, which is CL squared over 4. CL squared over 4, which is going to be equal, if we plug everything in, we have 10 newton seconds per meter times L squared, and L is 1.5 meters, so 1.5 meters all squared divided by 4. This is going to be equal to 5.625. So that's C prime. Okay. Then we're going to solve for K prime. And K prime, again, is just whatever is in terms of that in front of that theta term. So it's going to be KL squared plus MG. And also, I forgot to mention, to get from this here to this here, I added a small angle approximation. So when we have small theta, that means that cos theta is approximately equal to 1, and sine theta is approximately equal to theta. So that's why we got this theta term here. And then these would become 1, so they just cancel out. Okay. Okay, back to this. K prime, we just plug everything into here. K prime is equal to KL squared plus MG, which is equal to K, we're given that, that's 50 newtons per meter. 50 newtons per meter times L squared, which we said was 1.5 meters squared, plus the mass, which we're given is 2 kilograms times g, which is 9.81 meters per second squared. And this is going to be equal to 132.12. And then lastly, we have m prime. And m prime is whatever is in front of this theta double dot term. And that is just simply going to be 1/3 ML squared, which is equal to 1/3 times 2 kilograms times 1.5 meters squared, which is equal to 1.5. Okay, and so now that we have these terms, which are these numbers here, which you can directly plug into in front of this, we know how to get from this equation here, which is of standard form, we know how to get the damped frequency and the natural frequency. Okay, so let's start with a natural frequency. So the natural frequency omega n is going to be equal to the square root of k prime over m prime. And again, we have these, so we can directly plug them in. So this is the square root of k prime, which is 132.12 divided by M prime, which is 1.5, and that yields a natural frequency of 9.385 radians per second. Okay, but we're not asked the natural frequency, we're asked for the damped frequency. Okay, so the damped frequency is going to has the following form. Omega D is equal to omega N times the square root of 1 minus Z squared. Let me draw that better. Okay, and that is called the damping ratio. Okay, so the damping ratio is going to be equal to C prime over 2 square root of M prime K prime. Okay, again, remember these are all prime because these are based on this form of the equation, not the usual form with M, K, and C, because this is a different setup than a normal linear mass spring damper system. Okay, so we have all of these, so we can solve for the damping ratio. We can plug it in here. We have the natural frequency, and we can solve for the damped frequency. Okay, so this is going to be equal to C prime, we said is 5.625 divided by 2 times the square root of M prime, which is 1.5 times 132.12, and this is going to be equal to 0.2. Okay. And we know that this is an underdamped system, okay? Now, when we find omega D, we know omega N, which is 9.385 radians per second times square root of 1 minus 0.2 squared, and this is equal to 9.196 radians per second. And so omega D is equal to 9.196 radians per second. And this is our final answer for the damped frequency of this system. Okay. And to find the roots, we have R1, 2 is equal to negative C prime over M prime plus or minus I square root of 4 M prime K prime minus C squared over 2 M prime. So this is just the quadratic formula, equating all those terms to zero. And when we plug everything in, we get the following: negative 3.75 plus or minus I 9.196, and these are the two roots. So this is the final answer.